Hey, this be a video chart on WNBD. Been a long time follower of this one, and it's kept its popularity relatively high for many, many months, probably over a year now. But yesterday had a very nice move, and I got some people pointing it out to me. But I wanted to see how today reacted, mainly because yesterday was big in the sense that it was able to not only get above this purple line, but it put a nice close above it. And you look at the volume, so it was pretty much firing on all cylinders, breaking and closing above key resistances while putting in above average volume. And if we go back through the history of the chart, you can see, let's see, it's been the last time the price was above this purple line was back here in May. So literally many, many months since the price was able to get above this level. So I wanted to see how it reacted today. You know, it was in kind of uncharted territories in the sense of it hadn't been in this location above the 50-day simple moving average for you know a long time, and then today you know to not sugarcoat it was pretty disappointing. You know the price came back down, you had big volume, so I don't know if there's a big seller in there or if the company's selling shares. I have no idea, but you know not quite the reaction you know you'd want to see after such a nice day yesterday. Now, with that being said, is there still hope? Yes, the daily chart, there's still hope for it if it can maintain these levels. And what am I talking about? Well, we're still above these two short-term moving averages right here. And for the longest time, even the short-term has been bullish, as can be seen by these declining blue and red lines here. But as I tried pointing out, let's try it again. If you look right here, the price is above both of these lines, and it's come down here and tested them twice so far, and they have held as support, so that's a good sign. So probably a better way to see this would just be to draw a line right here at 003, as that's going to be the key area right now, where if the price can stay above there, then the daily chart's got a chance to really start to put in some new highs. The reason being, let's say you know the price comes down here and just hovers around 0.003 without it falling, and then heads back up. Well, now what we have is we have a set of lows right here, and the previous set was down at this area. Obviously, this set is higher than that set, and if you've watched my videos before, you know I love to talk about uptrend lines, and having something like that would give us the ability to draw an uptrend line. So that's why from the daily chart, you know, yes, today, looking at solely today was disappointing, but the daily chart as a whole is maintaining this area of support, and as long as that remains the case, and you know it does have an ability to start to turn this trend around. Obviously a long-term uptrend needs to start with a short-term one, and you can see that both the 10-day and 20-day are starting to go sideways now. So the short-term trend has actually been turned to neutral right now. Now it's just a matter of getting these to turn up, and if 0.003 can continue to hold, these levels will start to turn up, and you know you'll get the trigger into a bullish short-term trend. But this 50-day is going to be the key level. You know, you're not too far below it right now, but the price does need to get back above it and ideally maintain it. In terms of resistance levels, besides the 50-day, we also have 0.004, and that's where it got rejected today. And just going back through the history of the chart, it should make sense on why this is a resistance. So I will change this to red. But if we go back here, you can see that it was a support couple days here, and then support for about 2 weeks straight there. When it did fall, you can see resistance, resistance, and then once more today, resistance. So 0.004 is going to be another key area of resistance. But the good news with that is if you can get above 0.004, then the resistances start to thin out. I won't go into those right now. We'll first, you know, one step at a time, make sure that this 0.03 hopefully can maintain itself. And then with any sort of closes above 0.004, you know, that would definitely justify coming back with another update. So if there are any other questions on the chart, please let me know. If not, I'd encourage you to check out bullwarriorstocks.com. If you go there and sign up for the free newsletter, you'll be sent a free ebook. And with your newsletter subscription, you'll get chart setups, trade ideas, educational pieces, all sorts of things from penny stocks up to big boards. So there's a good variety, something for everybody. It is all free. So I'd encourage you to head to the website, sign up, and give it a try. One more time, this was WNBD. Thanks for listening.